Saute garlic, onion, and 3 tablespoons of canola oil until softened. Then add celery.
Yeah, we were going to do a skit where I'm actually using power tools, but I didn't start drinking early enough. So I have 20 Little Necks. Let's just count them and make sure. Now, if we had smell-o-vision, you would smell how delicious this smells. Yeah, so I came here yesterday, and my brother's lovely wife made chili, which the state of Massachusetts does not allow me to consume, specifically the Department of Public Safety, due to the gastrointestinal problems that may come about afterwards. So I was like that dog that just found, you know, that dead animal. I did the look around, and then I hurried up and gobbled up the chili like, you know, nobody's business. It's very good. These are messy.
Do you need to wash the
shellfish? Yeah, I think we're going to need to wash those because I see a little mud. These are the farm-grown mussels, which are just as good as the fresh ones. The nice thing is they don't have they're usually a lot cleaner, which they seem to do. What's nice with these farm-grown, they don't have the beard, you know? They don't look like they've been homeless for a decade. They're the yuppie version of the mussel. And I mean yuppie in the best way possible. No, I don't.
Does that mean there's less sand and impurities when you cook them?
Yes. Because if you find one of them has the mud in it, it can ruin the whole meal. Like, there you go. Here's a one full of mud. You bag it. What happens, sometimes the mussel's female counterpart throws them out, so all that's left in the shell is mud. And there's no apparent reason, but mussels are very angry, especially the female mussel.
Now, do you have the stove on medium or high right now?
It's on.
It's medium?
I don't know. What I do is I'm trying to shuffle the mussel shelf side to side. It's not an easy thing to do. But if it actually shifts and opens, that means the mussel's dead. Mm-hmm. So that's the one you don't want to put in. So far, we've only had one bad mussel. Speaking of mussels, I tore my bicep a few years ago, very painful.
By the way, how much mussels did you purchase?
I got exactly 2 pounds of mussels and half the amount of Little Necks.
And we're talking about the mussels from Maine, right?
Yeah, they're from Maine. Yeah, that's it. Whatever you want. I'm cooking this really slow. The farm mussels that I'm using probably farm locally, I would hope.
So you're cooking the mussels and the clam in chicken broth?
Yep. Mussels love chicken broth. I mean, they don't get it too often when they're in the ocean, so when they get out of the ocean, it's one of their favorite things. A little more hot sauce. I do this a couple of different ways. Sometimes I cook the mussels in the sauce, but tonight I'm not doing that because I've found in the past it's actually better to cook them separate. So what do we do now is we pause for a beverage. My brother is not funny, that's him right there. He just walked by.
I just don't feel funny today.
He doesn't feel funny today.
Very difficult. Catch you another day.
He's a very difficult man to work with.
So now the red pepper goes in. And the green pepper.
Add a can of crushed tomatoes and simmer for 20 minutes.
Put in a little next in.
Nora, this is not Hollywood. Don't shush me.
You don't steam them right in the sauce?
I do some. I used to, but now I do it this way. Because if you have a bad one, you can catch it before you ruin your sauce. And I did check them. Phil over there, I think, huh? I like to add a little bit of butter while I'm steaming them. And this is not a complicated meal, it's pretty easy.
The sauce been cooking for 15 minutes?
I think we cooked it a little longer because I was out on the deck drinking.
Cooking in a chicken broth and 2 tablespoons of butter. So how long do you cook that for about?
Till they start opening.
So about ten minutes?
You really can't put a time on the seafood. Only because sometimes they're different sizes, and the size can vary, not that much, but enough where you can't put a specific cook time. I have this nice platter here. It's a nice big platter. I like a flat platter, and I'll put my pasta on the bottom, and then I'll put my sauce on top. So this is the platter of which I'm using.
It's very Italian.
Yes, it's very nice. I'm actually going to put a little bit of the pasta in so they can dry.
So this is a pound of angel hair?
It's 12 ounces of fresh angel hair. You can use, there's several different products you can use. You can use dry angel hair, that's just as good. It still cooks about the same time.
So usually the angel hair cooks for about 5 minutes or so, or this is fresh angel hair?
It's about the same time. It's still going to take about 5 minutes. It's funny on these packages, it doesn't give you a specific time. It says cooked till al dente, which I find funny. Some people don't put oil. I like just a little oil in my water. You can do whatever
and
you
salt.
Want when you make a recipe.
Yeah,
put a little salt. You know, about a tablespoon. And then you'll see it. Because it's fresh, it seems like it's cooking faster, but it's really not. It cooks all about the same time. When I used to cook with my father on Friday nights, my mother used to work, and I was the youngest of three, and my father was a very astute cook, and he shared a lot of these recipes with me that he learned in cooking with his mother. And his mother, you know, I mean, she would make many different dishes, and a lot of Italian meals are meals that are peasant meals. Like, mussels were not something people normally ate before in the States here, because, you know, they didn't realize how delicious they were. I've been eating this with my father and my uncles for years, and I enjoy it. My uncle owned a bait shop right on the river called the Creek Bait Shop in Jamestown Island, and we used to prepare mussels marinara back then. But we didn't have it with pasta. We would just have it with the red sauce and the mussels. And then, you know, I just loved it because I always loved shellfish. And I was a young man, young adolescent when I first enjoyed that. And so these are the type of things that pass on through the generations. But the food is a good continuity for family, because you'll always remember a good meal.
Some people put some wine in the mussels and clams when they...
Yeah, they make a red wine sauce. We could do that, but I drank all the wine, so we're not going to be able to do that.
So we don't have any wine.
We pretty much drank it. So, here we are. I'm ready to assemble. I'm gonna check my pasta. The seafood's ready. Like Angel here for a couple of different reasons. I just like the thin pasta. If I was serving this meal for a lot of people, I would use like a mezzo rigatoni or ziti, because it's a little better for serving. But because we're only a few people, I like using the string portion pastas, either spaghetti or Angel here or linguine. I don't mind a little water on the bottom. It'll dry out. It'll evaporate. And the sauce, it'll blend with the sauce. It'll all be good. I may have overcooked this a hair, but it'll all be fine. I like to mix them up a little bit before I put it on the pasta, and then I'll put some of the ones that aren't in the mix just around the top. I'm spilling stuff all over the stove, and and I'm probably going to get yelled at by my brother because he couldn't be here because he's not funny today. But he will be cleaning. There's some chunks of garlic in here. This is really good stuff. I got some people I work with that I don't like very much, and when I see them, I'll be going, "Hi!" right in their face, you know, freak them out. Some of the little nicks don't appear to be open. A lot of times they'll open up. If they don't open, don't eat them. And that's that. Mussels marinara.
And the parsley and the basil?
I'll put that on. Right on the top like this. Almost forgot. That's why it's nice having you here. I live alone. I knew you single women looking, you know, for a guy to cook for them and then break up after a few meals. There you go.
Well, I think you're a catch, Steve.
Oh, well, that's nice. You have to say that.
So
here we are, mussels marinara.